All right, go around this way.
We're here in Shishlui Imifolozi National Park with Nunu Jobe. He is a barefooted white rhino whisperer, and he's going to take us on foot out into the park to get up close and personal with white rhinos.
So if you can see here, it's only grass in it. So this is your white rhino.
In 2014, over 1,200 rhinos were killed here in South Africa. And this year, thousands globally still continue to be killed for their horns for use in Asian medicines and also as ornaments.
So I'm Nunu Jobe, the ranger in from Isibindi Africa Trails. It's not a job, it's a lifestyle. It's that I can say. It's very difficult really to say what is it. It's the way of how we're supposed to live, to see the balance that nature has been created, and it's always give you that, you know, like the sense of belonging. From my background, I was a poacher. I remember when I was out there poaching, there was a point where like I can just look at the animals and say, wow, but they look so beautiful. So if you look at this one, you can see the twigs. It's from our black rhino.
Black rhino.
Black rhino, yeah. But remember, you can confuse this one with the elephant one. See? Four. Rhinos, they can hear very well. So when it's like this, it's a strong wind. So if you come around, you can approach them better using this kind of wind. If I feel like I can go close, I can go close. If I feel like not, then I don't even do it. So I don't force myself. I just feel like, okay, maybe I can do it or I don't do it.
This is a special moment. Two pairs of rhinos have come together and they're greeting each other by rubbing their horns. It's rare to see the social interaction of a crash of rhinos. I can't believe how close we are.
We're just walking along and Nunu suddenly stopped and said, look at this. Trapdoor spider. We were looking at the ground, we couldn't see anything, and then suddenly you just saw this little round hole.
Yeah. It's coming, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming.
How big does a spider get?
They can go maybe up to this size.
How does he make his little house here? It's amazing.
This made up of silk or web, mixed with a little bit of soil and some vegetation. This one always keep the door shut, and then unless if you feel like something coming around, because they hunt by ambush, so if they feel the vibration, they come right close. Okay, this is a cricket, or it's something that I can overpower, comes out, pounce in it, and then pull it back in.
You can see by being barefoot, it allows them to be so quiet and get really close to the animals. We're making so much noise of our hard boots clomping around the equipment. He moves like a ghost through the savannah, through the bush.
When you come here, it's nice and warm. He'll come here and then before he does his business, he's going to open this one. Whoop, 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 then go, then again kicks it.
Nuna's just climbed the tree. He's trying to find the rhinos for us. They're somewhere in the valley, and that elevation from up there is giving him the arcs to find them. He's got amazing eyesight as well. I'm gonna go and try and join him, but I don't reckon I can get as high as he can. Wait for me.
Yeah, I can see them there.
Got two straight ahead. We think we've found the dominant male. Nuna's just gonna close in. Come on, let's follow him. Nunu's found the two rhinos just up in the clearing there. The big male, he's awake now, he knows we're there. He's really, really calm. And now he's up.
The reason why we can't live in harmony, it's very easy. Well, we are very selfish creatures, you know. We always think about ourselves a lot and then not really about others. And then so I can try to find a balance and say, okay, we all have a right to live and let us share the space accordingly. If we can all be creatures, then we can all find a common ground, then we all live in peace.